Analysts have identified Russia's approach to its chairship of the BRICS meetings as very specific and focused on economic growth, which is good news for South Africa and Africa.
Because South Africa does not have the luxury of just being in a group for prestige reasons. It has to, over time, show that this can lead to boosting the economy, can lead to increasing investment, because South Africans do not have patience with simply spending our monies on these platforms, and they don't have meaningful impact on that.
BRICS has come a long way since South Africa hosted their first meeting, when, for the first time, the group included an official outreach program for continental African countries. There have been some concrete benefits.
African countries were able to stake their claim, build their relationships, and that led to the Russia-Africa summit in many ways, where it needed to concretize many of the things that started out in the outreach. Diplomatically, outreach also helped to place Africa in that league of countries that have influence globally.
It's one thing setting up those relationships and creating the conducive environments, analysts say. It's quite another to develop the sentiment into economically viable projects.
The benefits also depend on what Africa does to bring forward bankable projects, to bring forward concrete proposals that the BRICS might assist with. And that has always been a challenge in all of Africa's relations with others, with Europe, with the US.
Turning to the new development bank, Professor Zondi says that the bank may consider accepting new board members sooner than the BRICS group would invite new members to join its main group.
The benefit for Africa is to be to add another source of development finance, critical for infrastructure development, especially for agricultural production and for digital transitions, because that's what the things the new development bank is finances quite more liberally than other areas. And that all of the finance will be very critical for Africa's own economic recovery, especially after COVID-19.
I'm Angelo Coppola for CGTN in Johannesburg, South Africa.